It appears the fates have conspired in our favor, eh, Meg?
Look, stay away from me, Neil. Just because we're working together does not mean I have to like you. Give it to me!
What's that?
Give it to me, Neil! Give it to me! Give it to me, Neil!
Yeah, that'll work just fine.
Dad, how do you know Neil will show up?
Don't worry, Meg. I sent him an invitation he couldn't refuse.
Strange. These conventions usually have Segway parking. Hello? Am I too late for the Q&A?
Yeah, but you're just in time for the T&A.
Mrs. Griffin, what are you...
Shh, 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 shh. You can call me Mystique.
Mrs. Griffin, this is wrong.
Well, well, well. Look at this, Meg. Your boyfriend is violating both your contract and my wife.
Meg, I wasn't doing anything. Mrs. Griffin was just... How you're bending it?
I don't care. You've nullified the contract. I'm free!
Free? I don't understand, Meg. You don't want to be my girlfriend?
Well, I thought I did, but I guess I was just jealous.
I see. Well, Meg, I want you to be with me because you want to be with me, not because you have to.
Thank you, Neil.
Cecilia, it's the Goldman. How about we fire up the old Segway and find a nice, quiet field to do long division in? I mean, a nice, quiet field in which to do long division, sorry. Sorry, everybody. Okay, I'm on my way. Say, Meg, looking sharp. You want to go out after the game tonight?
Neil, I'm a flag girl now. I'm way too cool to be seen with you.
Really? Not even if I smoke this corn cob pipe? Again?
Thanks for doing my book report, Neil. And I didn't even have to change the handwriting because you write like a girl.
You should see me throw. Listen, Meg, would you want to go to a movie sometime?
You know what? I'd like that. It's a date. Okay, well, I'll see you later. Home ec just got out. I'm gonna go lick all their bowls.
Hey, Neil.
Oh, hey, Chris.
You sure are spending a lot of time with my sister lately. You know, if I didn't know better, I'd think that fish are ghosts. And I'd also think you're putting the moves on Meg.
Listen, Chris. You're my friend, so I have to confess. My sitting with you at lunch was part of a carefully laid out plan to get close to your sister.
What?
Like, I know it sounds terrible, but still, we've had some good times together. We even got Sean Penn to dress up as my dad.
Go away! I never want to talk to you again!
I don't think so. Neil, I'm a little out of your league. Besides, I'm going with Lando.
Really? Because my underground sources have informed me that Lando's taking Connie Demigo.
What?
What do you think of that, Neil? Daddy bought you a girlfriend.
Excuse me, if anybody's interested, I already have a girlfriend.
There's no way... Wait, what?
You ready to go, honey?
You rejected me too many times, Meg. I couldn't wait for you forever. Besides, Cecilia thinks my psoriasis is sexy.
I can't believe he's over me. You know, this is nice. It's actually the first time I've been on a date since I got the nickname Gutterball.
It is nice. Here, hold still. Make a wish. What did you wish for?
This.
You used me just so you could date my sister!
Oh my God! Chris! I'm so sorry! What have I done?
Aw, crap.
What we need is a picture for the front page. Well, hold on a second. I gotta rinse my retainer.
I'm looking for something tasteful, like the Malaysia spread in last month's Vanity Fair.
That was so sweet. It was wicked awesome.
Finally, we go to Meg Griffin for a special Channel 5 Junior Anchor segment on the moon. Meg?
The moon. There's a reason no one goes there. It's cold, and it's ugly. And its surface is plagued with deep craters and jagged peaks. Oh, wait! That's not the moon! It's Neil Goldman's face. Recently, many of you saw me kissing this freak of nature. But if I didn't think I was seconds away from death, I would have never done it. I mean, who in their right mind would? Well, I went to the streets to find out. Would you kiss this guy?
Ugh, no.
No way.
No.
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 Oh, God, no. What's the matter with you? Ugh.
It's official. Neil Goldman is unkissable. Hear that, Neil? I don't like you, and I never will. Back to you, Tom. You.
Oh, get into my car. Neil, would you?
I would be honored.
Thanks. Look, Neil, I need an activity to get into Brown, and the paper is my last hope. Can I be a reporter?
I don't know, Meg. You never seem to be that interested in journalism, or journalists, such as myself.
You know, I never realized how smooth the skin between your acne is.
Okay, I'll give you a shot. I've never been able to get an interview with the mayor of Quahog. You get it, and I'll make you a reporter.
You got it.
Run, little rabbit, run. But someday our two worlds will be one.
I sure hope my face clears up by then.
Once Chris gets up there, my friend in the AV department will take care of everything.
Okay, Meg, remember our deal. I do this for you, and I have your permission to think about you later tonight when I'm in the tub.
Fine, Neil.
Awesome. I might even go lefty tonight. Stranger in the tub. Try to move in on my woman, will you, Tom Tucker? Well, no one crosses Neil Goldman and gets away with it. I added a little something to your coffee that I don't think you're gonna like. Here's your coffee, Mr. Tucker.
What the hell is in this?
Sweet and low. That's for trying to steal my woman.
Go back and bring it to me with urine in it like I asked.
Yeah. What I'm about to show you is a fight scene from Star Trek Season 1, Episode 18. And as a bonus, I'm going to identify when it's Shatner and when it's his stunt double, Fred Lubins. Let's watch. That's Shatner, of course. That's Lubins. That's Shatner. That's Lubins. That's Shatner. That's Lubins. Now that's Shatner. But when I freeze frame, you can clearly see Lubins' coffee cup sitting on that rock.
He is the biggest dork on the planet.
Oh, totally.
And so, because of his rough and tumble style of command, Captain Kirk is clearly superior to Jean-Luc Picard. Any questions, Meg?
No! Leave me alone!
Thank you, Neil, for that incredibly irrelevant presentation. We all know Captain Picard is the superior officer.
Hey, Chewbacca! Pass over, stupid, and I'm gonna prove it by breaking your nose!
Hey, why don't you pick on someone your own religion who can fight for themselves? And you're not so tough! You frequently opt out of swim class because of your gross microcephalic penis!
It's not gross. It's special. I can use it to reset my cable box.
Hey, Chris. I noticed you were sitting alone. You mind if I join you?
Sure, we both have hats. Makes sense.
Oh, thanks. Hey, can you check my back for kick me signs?
Oh, yeah, you got a couple. This one says you're a dirty kick.
That doesn't say kick, but thanks. I'll keep that one for my lawsuit.
Boys, I got a new home gym.
Why are you telling us that?
Just letting people know. Don't want anyone to get freaked out by the transformation.
I gotta say, it feels kind of weird having someone join me for lunch.
Well, it's only natural, Chris. You and I are social exiles. We're the Khaleesi and Jorah Mormont of this school.
Sure, I'll agree to keep the conversation going.
Well, time to break out my terrible Jewish bag lunch. Let's see. Smoked whitefish, herring and cream sauce, smoked sable. That's a different kind of whitefish. And for dessert, the only bad cookie in the world. Hey, what's it like buying food from school?
It's good. I know everyone back there, so they let me drink the corn water. Boy, it's so great having someone I can talk to.
I feel the same way, Chris. I think you and I could get along very nicely. Hi, Meg. You busy Saturday night?
Neil, you ask me out like once a day, and I always give you the same answer. No! God, I don't think I could have been any clearer the last time I turned him down.
Oh my God, we're gonna die. There's so much of life I haven't experienced. I never even got the chance to be some drunk college guy's last resort.
My years of expensive orthodontic work will be a total waste.
I never even had my first kiss.
It's not too late, Meg. I'm here for you.
I'm just saying, find someone really smart to take the SAT for you in exchange for money.
Did someone say Jewish?
Oh, hey, Neil.
Listen, is there any chance you'd be willing to take the SAT for me this weekend?
Sorry, Meg, I'm swamped. I'm taking my body into the shop.
I don't know what you've been doing to this thing, Neil, but you see this gunk? That ain't supposed to be there.
Well, just do whatever you can.
All right, I'm gonna go eat a sandwich with one hand and fill out the invoice with the other.
Hello.
Hi, name please.
Neil Goldman.
Goldman. Sorry, no Neil Goldman.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I meant to say Chris Griffin.
Griffin. Oh, here it is. Says you're supposed to be an usher. Well, you'll need this.
Name please.
Chris Griffin.
Griffin. I'm sorry, sir. Chris Griffin has already checked in.
Well, that's impossible!
Holy moly, Marcy Miller! She bought feminine products at my dad's pharmacy, so you know she's up and running.
Yeah, I wish I had the guts to talk to her.
Talk to her? Chris, no one talks to each other anymore. If you want to get a girl's attention, you text her a picture of your penis.
What? Really? Are you sure?
Oh, yeah. People who send their daughters to public high schools are basically asking for this.
Well, I did just get this new phone from my dad.
We now go to junior anchor Neil Goldman with exclusive Channel 5 footage from today's exciting scene.
Thank you, Diane. There may have been some sort of commotion on the rooftop, but the real story was inside the mouths of Meg Griffin and Neil Goldman, where a meeting of the tongues, a summit of saliva, established a new world order of love.
I can't dissect this pig, Mr. Kingman. It's against my religion.
Believe me, Neil, it's no thrill for the pig to touch a Jew either. Okay.
I'm glad Neil's over me anyway. I'm with Jake now. Right, Jake?
Maybe someday we'll get married and you can go up on me.
Neil, I want to be your girlfriend.
What?
I was wrong to drive you away. We belong together.
Of course, I'm understandably skeptical of your newfound affection for me.
You still got that contract our dads drew up? Give me that. You want to hook up?
Buy me something!
Well, Chris, looks like another day of nobody joining us for lunch.
Yeah, we never should have let that blind girl touch our faces.
Hello, lover.
Neil, what are you doing? I'm not your lover. I don't even like you.
Meg, I strongly suggest you hold my hand, lest you look like a slut.
Listen, you freak! Tell these people that there's nothing going on between us!
Oh, don't be afraid of the fire, Meg. I won't let you burn. Al, why haven't I leaped?
Ziggy says you can't leap until she loves you back.
Don't worry, I'll get her. Before I touch anything, is this a nut-free counter?
Well, I don't know, my dad's might have been on there this morning.
Oh, hey, Meg. I saw you stomp that pigeon today with your bare foot. Pretty powerful stuff.
Thanks. I don't like losing any part of my lunch. Look, I'd love to stay and talk, Neil, but I have homework and there was no toilet paper in the girls' bathroom.
Well, while you freshen up, maybe I could help you get a head start on that homework.
You do that? Wow, that'd be great.
Wait, Neil, I thought you and I were gonna go find unlocked cars and pretend we're driving them.
Sorry, Chris.
Booty calls.
The best way to disarm a bully is to befriend him. Watch and learn. Hey, what's up, my main man? Listen, if you ever need the scoop on the local babe scene, just ask.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Awesome.
Let's watch it one more time in super slow-mo. This is where we cease to be Meg and Neil and begin life anew as Neil.
That sounds pretty good to me. Traffic on 146 is backed up all the way to Mineral Springs.
What do you want, Neil? And why are you playing the news?
Oh, it's an old boombox. I don't own any cassettes, so I just have to play whatever's on the radio.
Shouldn't you be out with Meg?
Look, Chris, I'm sorry I lied to you, but I'd still like to be friends. And I hope... I'm sorry, I have to put the boombox down. The D batteries make it very heavy.
Neil, there you are! What the hell is your problem? I finally give you a shot and you abandon me in a movie theater?
I'm sorry, Meg, but my friendship with Chris is more important.
You're a jerk, Neil.
So what do you say, Chris? Can we hang out again?
Yeah, I'd like that, Neil.
Great. See you tomorrow.
This is 'cause I'm drunk.
Move out, Irish trash.
Great.
Hey, Meg, what's got four arms, four legs, and one set of lips? You and me at the winter snowball.
Look, Neil, I don't... Oh, my God.
Hey, Chris, guess who I just scored as my date to the homecoming dance? Vice Principal McGuire.
Really?
Yeah, her husband just died of ALS, so she is ready to get at it.
Hey there, strong guy.
Not now, Brenda. She says I have the body of a 50-year-old before it gets ALS. So who are you going to go with?
I was thinking of asking Kara Morris.
Why don't you ask her now? Her locker's right over there.
Yeah, okay.
Well, hello there, Meg.
Neil, I really can't be seen talking to you anymore. I have friends now, and some of them very popular.
I know. I heard Sarah is your lab partner. All those years of you rejecting me finally make sense.
What do you mean? Oh my God!
Wow, this is a lot more physical than I thought.
My favorite part of a woman's body is haunches. And this is all haunch, baby.
Hey, Goldman. Great job with sports today.
Thanks, Chris. We're almost ready for the important sports game.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Ruth. Good gender fluid shower?
Great gender fluid shower.
Oh, I can't believe we're going out. This is so cool. Neil, not so fast.
Meg, you need to fulfill your contractual obligations.
What are you talking about?
All right, Meg. According to the contract, every night you have to put on my pajamas. My mom's record is 12 seconds.
Neil, I think you're old enough to...
Go!
Neil, would you stop kicking?
It kicks!
Hold still!
Ow, my thumb!
Hold still!
Excuse me, sir. Would you like to buy some candy to send Jewish kids to a Jewish place to do Jewish things?
Will it get you out of my bar?
It sure will. Look who's still standing, bitch. Go buy yourself something nice in hell.